mean, let's start off with the fact that the president did address the nation. I saw your comments on the social media post that we put up, and I was like, no, no, but I'm Uganda. Hey, you are sadist, if I can put it in Shilaga Shumba's way. Jesus is the Lord. I mean, what did you expect? Bars and saloons are the only thing that are not working. What more do you want? They're not going to open anytime soon. I think I was affected by every parent who was watching last night was just like, please say something about these schools. He did. My name is Tina Fierce Warren. The show is A Scoop and Scoop, and it's proudly sponsored by Metropolitan University. Let's get into what's happening around my circles. I got up to a conversation on Facebook that made me hit my head so hard. I swear, I think if I put this wig off, you would tell I am swollen in the face. Ugandans were perplexed by the difference between an arcade and a mall. Did y'all see that? It was on Twitter, it was on Facebook. I'm in Uganda, but when they send an essay, they were writing essays. People went down to Wikipedia to like take screenshots of the difference. I'm like, who should we blame? It's the system, isn't it? It's this damn system, this education. How can we not know the difference between a mall and an arcade? What's a mall? But what's a mall? It's the big one. And then what's an arcade? Which is a small one? The small one can also be a kaduka. So apparently the difference is this. According to the person in studio, a mall is the big one with big shops. An arcade is the small one with small shops. What the? With very many small shops. Ugandans, mwedeko. Read. What do you think they've been doing? Has any of you called up any of your friends who have been in lockdown and just randomly asked them, so what you been up to during this lockdown? I have not seen very many people even lift a book and try to educate themselves. I have not seen anybody trying to learn a new skill just to better equip them for the next if all hell breaks loose situation in the world. I have not seen. The most all of you did was try to run out and jog. You are excited. What happened? What happened to taking looking after yourselves? Hey, we want to jog. You went and jogged. They told you to jog from home. What is happening to half of your fat now? Is it jogging on its own in your body? I'm just asking. Because if you want to tell me that you have gone into 3 months of lockdown without a job and nowhere to be, that you're going to come back the same way you were 3 months before, is that even fair to the human brain? Because I thought we learn something every day. Anyway, every time I call a Wikipedia, Google, what language do you think we should be learning? We are going to speak Chinese, ladies and gentlemen. Learn how to say ni hao. Ni hao. Or meow. Ha! On Friday, I was with you guys and I was trying to... I don't even think that's called apprising you of a situation, because the whole Brian White thing. I see people are still taking it serious, but now... Anyway, I have desperately been trying to get to the bottom of this story and it doesn't add up. How many girls is there? We've seen two. Why do bloggers keep saying many other girls have come out too? Baliwa. Baliwa. Secondly, so Miriam Atembe tried to come in and talk for these girls and rescue them. We all saw how that went. And then Parliament took a moment to talk on it and even appointed the human rights chair there, Awonga Parliament, to help, you know, bring these girls in, talk to them, and try to also bring Brian White in to have his side of the story. Guess you what? Akasajja kafana nange nsiringanyi. Tegas! He did show up! At all! Did he give an explanation? Nothing. All we know is he says that this particular thing the whole situation around him and the allegations is just a ploy by his enemies to see him go down. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to ask this question because I know most of you are asking yourself this question. Ibu, Mbulida, Brian Whitey alina chiche mwagalo kumutira. What? Last time I checked, he's a mufere like any one of them. Sicho, last time I checked, he doesn't even have a property that you can point out to and say, Ede takali ya Brian, e nyumba ya Brian, talinga mbuga, we mulabira mbuga ya vambu mufere. Rule number one, every mufere knows, I can tell you this, every mufere, it is like, Bufere 101, the first lesson is, you never buy ish in your name. That's how you know Mbuga left that ish. Okay, not entirely, but at least he owns properties in his name. Brian White ainakachi. Ainakachi. All the cars that we thought were his have been repossessed. It's like the repo man passes every day. The house that we used to go to so that they give us some kamane, he moved out of. Then he moved to another house. Someone tell me if Brian White has done anything significant after that Arua situation, because in Arua, when he went with Zari, I can speak on that because my company, New Vision, was in charge of their media coverage. After that, Mumbuli the Brian yakola chechida. After that, tell me Brian White came out and paraded his money the way he usually did. After that, tell me he again used the same lines he used to use for us. I'm trying to empower the youth out of poverty. Has he? Who's he been empowering? Negro, you need to empower yourself first. So, I'm sitting there and I want to believe it. So either they don't want material stuff from him, and they want what? What's in his head? Have you people seen that? We can't even see what's in his head. But we know what's in his head, given the fact he showed us. So, someone tell me why Brian White thinks someone would go beyond and below and above, sideways, fly, parachute, you name it, to put him down. Put him down from where? You cannot complain that they have put you down if you were never on any pedestal for you to step down to. So, podium. We put the podium down as soon as it came up. So which podium has he been standing on? Podium bade mchaji ulira. You cannot tell us to kuja ku podium, no. Ku podium kwa ye jako. Toina footing. Like, I just want to know. Because, you know what? I'm loving the year 2020 for particular reasons. Because when 2021 comes, we're gonna be woke. You people have been using this as a hashtag. Hashtag woke. Hashtag woke. No, true walking or waked. Which one do we use? True kuzunguka, that one, is going to be at the end of this year. Ask me why. First of all, we have a global pandemic that we have never faced as an entire generation. The last global pandemic that was held, that was hard, didn't have to suffer like us, because then their population of the world wasn't as much as of the youth. A little bit older and all of that. So now the millennials have faced a global pandemic. We have been harboring in so much nonsense. We have been following churches. We have been following particular celebrities. We have been putting emphasis on all the things that are so insignificant. So now that the time has come and all these issues died out, we're going to come out of this walk. People like Brian White. Now confusing a Kampala after COVID-19. Hats off. I will make that mufere my friend. I want to ask him where he gets the bravery to be a punk in a time when we can't stand punks. And I am to make him that way. And as for these girls, y'all have been attacking me, but I'm being insensitive and I don't understand the allegations of Rep Honey. If I went into that conversation, I would probably need 3 hours just to get to the bottom of it. Now these girls, they have allegations and we can't take that away from them, because that's their truth. At the end of the day, each of us as an individual walks by our truth. That's their truth. But then their truth keep jumping. 1 minute they are here, then the next minute they are here, then the next minute we are crying, then the next minute the state is standing for you, the next minute Kadaga is speaking on your behalf, then the next minute your mom is coming out and saying, nah, I ain't got no problem with Brian, he cool peoples. Then the next minute we're like, we cannot confirm that conversation or that source. The hell is going on? Change your girl. The way you decided to come out, that was bravery, right? See this ish through. Go to the courts of law. Probably have him tried. Probably get him even convicted. But you coming to social media, even if all of us on social media say, Chitoof, Brian Whitey about raping and about sexual harassing, are we going to arrest him? With a social media family? Are we going to take the law into our own hands and go look for him and tell him you're under arrest for harassment? No. We are powerless. So why don't you go to the people with the power? Let someone get these girls off social media. Take them to Hassan Kasinje. I like calling out that man's name. At Mr. Hassan Kasinje, please get these young girls to the right people who help them. I have dealt with that department in police. They are very thorough. Very thorough. You can't go there and make an allegation and they tell you, they are very thorough. Move up social media. Brian White. Tumusabire Saraj. Bangamba sobola gamba bantu bikotuko. Tumusabire Saraj, Brian White. Ageje. Should we pray that maybe when he puts on some weight? I don't know. Tumusabire Saraj. Zino, ye wache teka deyuje kava. You know how in the first weeks of quarantine, everyone was talking about how this is going to affect people because couples, blah, blah, blah. I waited for the couples and it seems, you know, let me tell you. If you are in a relationship right now, say a marriage, a fiance or boyfriend, and y'all have stayed together thus far during the past 3 months, baby girl, I just want to tell you, you are the chosen few. You are meant for each other. You are that thing they say, I found my soulmate, the love of my life. Because in these COVID times, Emigo, Ebivumo, I have somebody who called me out of nowhere, and I'm Tina. Bafuneje batuleka tugende, kubaba kazi tugenda baku batuba male, one mukamba, what type of coward are you to tell me mugenda kuba abakazi bamwe? You cannot stand your wives. Yo, I got a lecture, a full lecture. This guy told me, first of all, some of us, we married our women and we only saw our women for 2 years after marrying them. I'm like, but you all live together. He's like, no, you wake up in the morning, you dress up, you go to work. When you come back like a typical Ugandan father, tired, not talking to anyone. You go in your phone, talk to your side dish on the phone. And Saturday comes, we never parent our kids. Saturday, I have to go to the washing bay with my friends wearing moccasins and brown shorts. On Sunday, my wife is going to put the kids in the car and take them for church and then drive them around and give them ice cream. Then Monday resumes. I was like, anyway, do you know that half of the relationships that are breaking up right now, it's simply because these couples had forgotten who they married? Do you know that this quarantine has made people look at their spouses and go like, this is the best I could do? Did you know that this lockdown and quarantine has made us realize all the things we can stand and things we cannot stand about our partners? That's why I just wanted to take a minute and say, whichever marriage survives this, I swear, if you have a side dish, if you have a side guy, whichever marriage survives this, stay with that person. Side chick, side dish, whatever it is that you are, understand that if he has gone through a quarantine lockdown with his wife, he ain't never taken you. Yeah, that was the point. Side dish, go and get yourself a one more. Too much Charlie, yo. We're talking about important things. Then there is a dramatic promoter who thought that the very first social, no, that can't be social distancing. The very first anti-social distancing show / concert we as Ugandans should show up for is Rick Ross. Rick Ross. Now, the urban elite will say that's dope. The regular Ugandan will be like, I never even understand what that punk is singing about. Like, who thinks of these things? Mami atengene zako. Amana Uganda baba promoter baba. Baba era wa. They just crack and they, how do you bring us Rick Ross? How many songs of Rick Ross do you know? This is all I know about Rick Ross. I'm a boss. I got a chopper in the car. Huh? You don't think he does? Huh? No, they should actually start doing it this way. The very first anti-social distancing show introducing Nebalioka Bayiwa Oga CIA Nakamilioni Bebe Kulu Lydia Jasmine. Actually not Gasia Enna. Nebalioka Bayiwa Omubidi Gwaba artisti baffe. Bwema Maranga but never went there. Nemutu wa Gasia won. I'm just saying. But me doing a full Rick Ross concert. How many albums are those? How many rap lines are those? And he doesn't even have nice hooks I can jump to, man. So tell me, why would that, how much are they going to pay? What was the cover charge? Free. It better be free. I have nothing against Rick Ross. It's just, he wouldn't be my choice. You know, the choice I would want for the very first anti-social distancing concert in the country, it needs to have somebody, Tant. The only person who always delivers that effortlessly with ease in Uganda is Shaggy. Why don't we give Shaggy Obutuzo already? I know the national idea, I know mwana wa. Bandit related day onga chakademas and pliers, Shaggy. We just need to listen to feel-good music. Not some black American telling us how his diamond earrings cost what, but he has no education. I cannot. We're trying to grow Africa, not put it down. And then someone forwarded me a WhatsApp message, actually, coming in apparently from the Kampala Taxi Operators Association. The new adjusted taxi fares are as follows. First of all, when my president was sitting down yesterday, did you all hear him say something about they will adjust fares? Muraza mama nkaba deva to deka. Abantu be mugendo twala na baba deva to deka na mwe. So you begin telling me that you're now taking me from Chisasi to town kunkumi satu. What's the logic? You can't tell me that ntinda badenga meka. Lukumi okudda mu kibuga. Kati mbo ntwalira we nkumi biri kambuze amafuta bagongeza. Changing oil of amuchusiza. Kambuze driver. Omkono tuatanso kusasulira oguvuga. Who are these people, by the way? Are they the guys who own the taxis, or is it the guys who pay the imposer to own the taxis? Which one is it? I just need for them to give me the logic, because this ish happens in my country a lot. When Christmas time comes, they hike up prices. Then you ask yourself, why? It is the same car I have been using. It is the same amount of fuel I have been using. Why are you hiking? Why? Ekyokubiri bantu ba Mukama, bano abantu bwe mwagala okubba bwe muti, wallahi wakiriko banatambula. Ate Abannayuganda babawadde mu testi myezi gibadde emeka ebiri. Weren't they walking from home to town? Kati gwe owa taxi olowooza nkolera ku Jinja Road, ntinda nneme okutuuka ku bigere. Yet I have walked to Ntinda for the past 3 months. What's wrong with these people? And I call upon all Ugandans to actually say hell no. No way. It's unfair for everyone. Every Ugandan out here. It's unfair. No mugaga akaba ino korone bade taina ko mwavu, taina ko mugaga. O mugaga akaba na yaba koza beka yaba saze ko sente kubezize na yaba azisaze. And then you, a taxi tout, a taxi person, you feel it is okay. It is right bolo kuba bakugambyo twale half capacity. So you're like, if it's going to be half capacity, I have to make that money somehow. Did we bring corona? Is corona us? Tell us. My dear president, tuyambi. Kampala ebadde womye nnyo nga tetulina ba tax. If this is what they are going to get through. Two. No, it is simple. Mr. President, buy more Chibaluma buses. Buy more NMPA buses, but here it also has a new name. It is not Pioneer. The Pioneer is Chibaluma. Olona ya black and white jebale say nyitida zilingeze bwetu. Empia, ezo we are just going to call them empia. Gulira dala nyingi. Taxes ziwere. Ziwere mpaka bwe bana wombeka, bwe bana wombeka because you're not going to tell me. People, think about your mothers. There is a woman whose job has been okutunda obunyebwa mu kibuga. Nga yesibyeko enkumi bbiri ze yazimanyi zimutwala ne zimuzza. Naye enjala emulumidde mu lockdown eno. Aveyo ne bbiri ze zono zitwale ku trip emu nga naye talisuwa oba anatunda n'otunda muli balalu. Basajja ba taxi mwebereremu. Ate kati manye bameza akazimba ku mutima wano. Ekimango, they have ekimango. Because their boda counterparts have been killing it. Then be smart. Sell the taxis and buy bodas. Do deliveries. Abanayuganda echinyiza ko mugenda obiraba mu yombere. You're going to all just get angry on WhatsApp. You're just going to be like, hey, these guys. And then it will pass. Name one gamba one did denyo kanvene one. At VS1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and at Tina Fierce One. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce One with an H. I'll catch you on the flip side, which is tomorrow on a Wednesday. Who am I celebrating? Nobody. Has anybody seen a phenomenal woman lately? Like in my country? Who? Who? No one. Whether I'm waiting. Bali abakazi ba fevo na bali bogera ngani mutia. Bali wo. To anyone. I'll catch you tomorrow. I'm out. Peace.